Good evening. The news summary for this Sunday, 5th December. A comprehensive sexual education manual is being developed and finalized to teach children and young people about how to protect their sexual and reproductive health and other related issues. A workshop was held recently to validate the manual before handing it over to the United Nations Population Fund. This has been developed for young people in East and Southern Africa, but it is being reviewed and adapted in the Seychelles context to include school children and youth living with disabilities. Benjamin Vell is the consultant facilitating the workshop.
The Comprehensive Sexuality Education Manual is a manual that is a curriculum-based program that helps children and young people 10 to 24 years old to develop their skills, develop their knowledge, develop their attitudes, and develop values that will help to protect them, that will help to promote their health, and that will help them to look at life, to look at human sexuality in all its form. So it's not just a question of talking about sex, but it's a question of looking at how you feel, how you think, what you believe in, and how the kind of decisions you will make that will make sure that if you're a woman, that you do not have unwanted pregnancy. You, for both male and female, obviously, that they do not contract any infection transmitted by sex, including HIV, and also that we prevent sexual and gender-based violence. So it's all about health. It's all about living in your society in peace, living in your society in social relationships, sexual relationships that are healthy.
Seychellois who are traveling and visitors have a further option for their PCR tests. This is a new lab, the Le Niol Diagnostic Center, which is part of the PSM Medical Enterprises under the direction of Dr. Shitsi. Clients will call at Dr. Shetty's clinics for their tests, and the samples will be taken to the Center for Diagnostic. Previously, Dr. Shetty's clinic were carrying out rapid tests only. The Minister of Health, Mrs. Peggy Widot, who inaugurated the center alongside Dr. Shetty on Thursday afternoon, has commended the initiative.
For us in the Ministry of Health, we welcome such initiative because we feel each time there are new services being offered in Seychelles, it contributes to the availability of more services for our population. And in this instance, as we're testing for PCR, it's adding to the kind of surveillance that's required on a national level. So we welcome this initiative because we feel it will contribute to the response of the pandemic.
We had the place here, and it was already a branch of our health facility. So we didn't need to go and build something, apply for all the other things, but it was already there. And it just, we were doing Ayurvedic therapy before. Now with all the COVID, there's no distancing, all the social distancing. There's no need for that. We do less of that. So we put the lab in here. And it cannot be in the same, it would be difficult to put such a facility like this inside the clinic with all the rooms for separate things. But it's more convenient. People don't have to come here. They can come to our clinic. They can go to our testing centers. Just have the test done, and the results will be emailed to them. They don't even have to come back for the result. We publish one result by email to them within 24 hours.
The Minister for Education, Dr. Justin Valentin, has met with 8 students who recently completed their studies at professional centers and who also won the President's Cup for their respective institutions. This was in a short ceremony at the Ministry of Education this week. The main topic discussed were facilities for students to attend the university. The students had the opportunity to explain the difficulties they encountered encounter while making the applications, something which the minister said he will address the CEO for the Agency for National Human Resource Development, Nadia Loriko, was also present. The agency is responsible for facilitating students' application to universities, and the students had the opportunity to learn more about the procedures. A ninth student coming from SIAD was not present because he had already flown out to university in Malaysia. The students said the meeting helped them to see the reality compared to their expectations.
The meeting have enlightened us on the way of the course of the university on how to really budget for as many students to go instead of only one of us leaving for a scholarship, so more professional for the country. If you consider the cost for the university instead of just choosing a university for one student only.
That's the end of this news summary. Join me at 8 for the news bulletin in Creole. Until then, have a pleasant evening.